Hey guys, what is going on location out here in Cappadocia, Turkey? And today we are checking out some ancient underground cities and caves.
Göreme in the region of Cappadocia. Got up early today. And I'm not the only one, there's some other people. We are all waiting for the hot air balloons, which I think usually come out at sunrise. And I have seen no sign of them, which is a little bit concerning after coming all the way out here. The surroundings here are very beautiful. These are the fairy chimneys. Interesting rock structures that you see all around, at least all around Göreme. And a lot of the, I thought it was just my hotel, but a lot of these places are built right into these fairy chimneys. And you get these cave hotels. I thought I was special staying in a special place. It seems like every hotel is a cave hotel. Show you the hotel anyway, pretty cool. Got a nice terrace. So I'll go ahead and show you my room. It's got a heater, so it's not actually that cold. Looks cold. Well, it's got a nice view. Turns out that the balloons were canceled this morning because it was too foggy, but there are still things that we can explore out here. It's pretty clear now. Gonna walk out of town, go on a little hike, and then check out an underground city. I'm not 100% sure where I'm going. This guy's been following me around for a while now. I'm kinda just heading out that way. Keep going. Well, it seems like he's gonna try to get food from some other hikers. I don't have any food for him. But we continue. It is a bit chilly out, and I don't have a winter coat or anything, so I'm actually wearing this poncho that I got in Ecuador. I was hiking up a volcano, and it was getting pretty high into the altitude, like 4,500 meters. It was pretty cold. I ended up buying this poncho. It is not my first poncho. I also have a poncho from Bolivia, but I really like ponchos. It's like wearing a blanket that just goes around with you wherever you go. I'm a big fan of ponchos. Oh, look at this. It's quite an enormous cave castle. So the story behind all these, they're called fairy chimneys, are that back in the Roman period, a lot of persecuted Christians fled to this area in Cappadocia, and they found that this material was soft enough that they could carve it out. So they made underground cities, which we're going to check out. They also made churches, stables, houses. This is enormous. Somebody's room. There are a couple entrances along the ground here, but I don't know how you get up to there. Those windows. In these spots. Yeah, nowhere to go. Might be a church. Looks like this is a church. Well, I'm not sure. Maybe some stairs eroded away or got sealed off, or they used a ladder or pulley system to get up there. But there's a lot of little entrances in all these fairy chimneys. So I saw this. Rose red. Is it a sign from the early Christians? Kind of intrigued. Pretty cool shapes though, the wind and water erosion. Got some ATVs going. Oh, is this how they get up there? Not quite, but it's a nice view. Slide down, do I? Well, definitely didn't bring the right shoes for this kind of activity. Pretty steep. All right, get out of that. See all these birds posting up on the fairy chimneys. Very convenient. I don't think any cats can get up there. Oh, you never know. Cats are pretty crafty. This kind of reminds me of just like the Badlands of North Dakota. Went there when I was a kid. My grandparents, my brothers. Although obviously they weren't carving out homes and of ancient civilizations living inside of the formations. This is the advanced group. I'd be in the group where there's a guy walking and pulling the horse along. I'd be like, hugging the horse's neck. That's pretty cool. That's pretty fun, actually. I just took a bus from Göreme to Nevşehir and then transferred in Nevşehir to Kaymaklı, which is a home, one of the underground cities. We're gonna check out this underground city. I've looked around online and seen different figures for how many underground cities there are in Cappadocia. The highest number I've seen is over 200. The lowest figure I've seen is 36. But two are open to the public. One of them is right here, Kaymaklı underground city. Let's go check it out. I'm excited. Made it inside. This is the entrance. So red arrows to go in, blue arrows to go out. All right. From what I've heard, this particular underground city, Kaymaklı, goes down 8 stories, I guess. Maybe you call them stories. But only 4 are open to the public. I also heard that it's kind of like the wealthier families have places up towards the surface, and then the poorer you are, you're further and further down.
If you are claustrophobic or a professional basketball player, you might have a problem. It's kind of hard to imagine, but they estimate that 3,500 people lived in here. Again, it was here. Well, famous for the early Christians and the Byzantine era, when the Arabs came, they had to hide underground, literally. But I think this goes back to the 8th century BC. So I read about these. It's a stone door. And what this was for is, if the underground city got breached, they would have a bunch of people run up into one of these alleys here, and they would roll this to cover the entrance. They'd have 6 or 7 guys roll this, cover it up, and protect those people, and kind of, I mean, they would just be stuck inside, but they'd be alive. So, heading down deeper into the city here.
In total, it goes down 80 meters. The public is able to go down 20 meters right now. And there are ventilation shafts to the surface on all levels, you know, so people can breathe.
There's 3,500 people living down here. I'm guessing that each one of these is like somebody's house. I mean, that's just somebody's spot. Not a lot of personal room. I can't imagine being down here for more than an hour or two. This is worse than that nuclear bunker in Albania, even though I didn't post that video yet. If there was a nuclear attack, I had to live down here with this many people, I'd leave. I'd go out.
Well, I think this is one place that I will see that Shaquille O'Neal will never get to see. Unless he's pulled in by on a sled or something. Holy cow. Okay. Here is the winery.
Guessing it must have been a pretty popular spot to hang out. Seeing as nobody can see the light of day. Probably all candle lit. And it looks like now you're heading back out. So we must be at the lowest point that, you know, we're allowed to go, which is 20 meters under the surface. It's a bummer. There's a guy kind of freaking out not far. He's claustrophobic and asking me how to get out. And I said, blue arrows. He's like, no, right now. So he went back up the red arrows. But if he had gone through one more tunnel, we'd have had a nice stairway back. I think it goes up pretty far. Absolute maze.
be like jumping down there. I don't even know where these voices are coming from.
Yeah, it's crazy.
I'm gonna get lost. Holy cow, yeah. Look at this. What the heck is this? What's this? All right, heading up. It's a wooden staircase. So I think that means we have successfully navigated Kaymaklı, or at least the part that's open to the public. We're coming to the end of the underground city tour. I'm very happy about the timing. I heard to go around 1 or 2 p.m. because if you go earlier in the morning or later in the evening, you got tour groups of 50 people. It's just packed and claustrophobic and in a mess. So pretty happy with how that turned out. Oh, all right. Hey, look at that. They sell ponchos here. Awesome. Nice. Love to see it. A lot of carpets, rugs all over the place, at least in Cappadocia. We have made it back to Göreme. Sun is starting to set. So this might be the only Cappadocia vlog that you come across that does not show any hot air balloons, except maybe this. If that counts. I'm not finished yet though. There is some food specific to this region, and I want to go and eat some right now. So I've got this nice corner spot with a view. The table is pretty small, so I can't show you the food and myself at the same time. But don't worry, there's no food yet. I did get this though. This is a Cappadocian shot up. And I thought that was a type of grape because Cappadocia is a famous wine growing region. But I found out shot up is wine in Turkish. So this is just a red wine. They didn't tell me the brand. I think it's just a house wine. And because it's a mountainous region, from what I understand, there's a lot of just local vineyards. People have a few acres and they grow their own grapes. So let's see if it's any good. This is a very drinkable wine. I like it. Okay, we got our first appetizer. Let's take a look. It is a salad. So you can see it's kind of separated. All right. Oh, wait, can I get a video? Sweet. All right, I don't know what's going to happen. So this is testi kebab. Yes, pottery kebab. Whoa. Wow, thank you. That looks really good too. That's great. I had no idea there was a presentation involved and I was just recording. Here is our food for today. And
This is gonna be great. I already know it. I can smell it. Amazing. We got some onions. So as you saw, pottery kebab. Pretty cool presentation. Then this testi kebab or pottery kebab is from this Cappadocia region. So I don't know how available it is outside of here, but I definitely wanted to try it. I didn't know it came with all the fat, the pottery, but it's very good. So guys, thank you so much for watching. I apologize that there was no hot air balloon ride. I was looking forward to it. It just doesn't look like it's gonna work out. I could stay another day, but I don't know if the weather is gonna be all right, and there are other cities and places in Turkey that I really wanna go see. So I'm gonna head on to the next place. But I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please give it a like. Please subscribe if you haven't. I'd love to see you back in the next episode or in episodes after that. We got a lot more coming your way. Stay tuned.